Hello, welcome to Science Talk. Today in the studio with me is our guest, student biologist Jordan Cox. How you doing? What are we talking about? I'm doing good, man. Thanks for having me on the show. Big fan of your work. It's an honor to be here. Today I'm going to talk to you about reproduction and mainly fertilization. So the best place to start is with the sea urchin. It is the most studied and most understood species on the planet when it comes to fertilization. They have external fertilization, so they have gonopores on top of their bodies where they release their gametes or their sperm and their egg through gonopores, which are connected directly to their gonads. Now, I'm going to have to talk to you a little bit about the anatomy of the egg because it's going to be important about the structural changes that are going to happen. So in the egg, you have that egg plasma membrane, which is where deep down inside the maternal haploid nuclei lays with its DNA waiting for the other half to form a zygote. Then you have a little space, then you have another membrane that is called the vitellin membrane. Then outside of that, you have the jelly coat. And within your egg, you have what's called cortical granules, and those are going to be important, real important here in a little bit. So here's our regular sperm cell. It's got a tail, it's got a mid piece where it has its mitochondria, and it's got a head that has the DNA. And as you can see, as it comes in contact with the jelly coat, some things happen. It produces more ATP for energy, and it starts to form that acrosomal tip that you saw fusing with the outermost membrane. Now, when that fusion happens, the outer membrane is no longer called the vitellin. It's now the fertilization membrane. The inside's still the egg plasma membrane. And as soon as it starts to fuse, the inside of the egg starts to change. The space between the two membranes expands due to the cortical granules that you'll see here releasing exocytosing their contents and raising the concentration of calcium in between those two. The head of the sperm there is dissolved and the nuclei is ready to slide in. We gotta patch up this membrane so that nothing else can come in there. And that's what is happening next. All right, so we have an egg, and what you'll have here is what's called syngamy. And syngamy, depending on your textbook versus your professor, there's a couple different ways you can explain it. I personally like to go with my professor's explanation, Dr. Kathy McDowell, who says that when two nuclei are within the same cell, those pronuclei automatically make up syngamy. Now, your textbook and some other people disagree and say that it's not until two haploid nuclei have fused together that you have syngamy, but either way, you get the idea. The DNA's in there. The patch right there is actually kind of an interesting thing. The membrane that had been dissolved, part of it was saved from that sperm cell and used to patch that inner membrane back up. Now, with the releasing of those cortical granules earlier, one of the most important things is that it leads to these blocks of polyspermy. Polyspermy is a fancy way of saying that we don't want more than one dad per baby. No one does, really. And the way it does that is through the releasing of that calcium, and it starts these blocks so that no other sperm cells can get in there. And the best way I thought to illustrate that was the Starship Enterprise there, and it's force-filled with the torpedoes that are being deflected. It's the same idea. You could think of the ship as the actual DNA. Okay, well, thanks for having me. I think that's all the time we got, and blah, blah, blah.